How you going, team? Welcome to another video. Back at the truck, I've got Poe and B. My other dog, Pace, is at home right now, nursing a wound from the boar we caught last Sunday. Anyway, heading away with my mate Simon. I'm not sure if his dad's coming today or not. Hopefully he is, because he's a good bastard. It's John. But right now, I'm going to pick up young Jody. I'm on a waker. So Sunday afternoon, I'm running a bit late. Had to get my chores done. Just starting to rain, and I haven't bought any wet weather gear. Should have, but no, I should be right. Got a nice thick woolen jersey. And when it gets wet, wool isn't too bad. Remember, don't wear cotton if you're going out and it's wet, because you'll get cold and you'll bloody suffer. We have arrived. She's nice and cool up here. We've all rooting down here. Perfect breeze coming this way. It's about a 5-knot wind. Gully straight down there. Poe's out there now. Bee's out there about 50. So I'd expect that something will happen very soon. Simon says there's a good boar hanging around over here since we're... Buck! There we go, buck. That's a pup, isn't it? So I'm Simon's pup. That's the pup, fuck it. He just told the pigs we're all here. Now they're back in. Bit of old nosing there. Just extended this long range aerial. Pose 150 out here. Look at that, mate. There's a circle on that there. Have you guys see that? At the very end of it there.
Tight circle. And
this rooting here is not so old. Got Poe out here 120, but I've got B over here 320. It's a nice night to catch a pig. Real pig country. Sounds like Mix come back in.
Mark, come here.
So Poe and B have just tracked around to the stream here, about 120 away. It's us here, just having a look. Not moving real fast. They are together, so that's good. Be up here and a couple of barks going off.
Get your heart and lungs.
Found a pig.
Working.
Come on, B, you got a pig down here.
Hunting's not for the meek. Get your heart and lungs. Working boy. Head on down to the creek. Get your heart and lungs. Working boy. Go to the wailing sound. Head on down. Head on down, head on down, to the wailing sound. Head on down, head on down, head on down, to the wailing sound. Head on down, head on down, head on down, to the wailing sound. Working boy, hunting's now for the meat. Head on down, head on down.
Good boy.
Head on down.
Just a fucking ripper.
To the creek.
She's a beauty. Drag up there, mate. What a bloody ripper. Shoot, you have some fun, boy, don't you, with us? Hey?
Bad luck's come to an end. Stop licking my face. Get out, mate.
Here, Doc. Oh, just loves you, that's all, mate.
Not ideal.
Simon's the arsehole eliminator. Did you flip and stick it? Or yep. Side stick it? Good man.
I flipped it.
Good boy. You got it right on the money there.
Started off a bit too high. Really bad at guessing a weight when they're running around the bale.
So Simon's done a few of these by now. Just hold it nice and fair. That's perfect, mate. Well done. Good teamwork. Awesome. Nice and clean. That's the way.
Good to go. All
right.
You watch how to do this here, Jody. Pay attention, mate. So he's got one through on one. You don't have to do it that way, but you can treat it through afterwards if you want. But so he's cutting there. You can actually do it with you can actually do it with just one tie too.
Mm.
But this is pretty much bulletproof and they don't break, eh, Si?
Nah, as long as they're tight and they can't bounce or anything.
Yep. So he's pre-cut that already. Yeah, they pup. Actually makes it very comfortable on your back. Your hands are a wee bit shaky there, so look, you get a bit low on sugar in your blood, might need another aeroplane.
I'm all good. She's starting to cool off.
It's cooling off a fair bit. Good job, mate. Well done. Gonna find out, just roll over onto your side. Get the stick out of the way.
Get in.
Use your core strength when you're standing up. So concentrate on your tummy muscles. You feel that?
Yep.
Just keep your core tight. That's how you carry heavy pigs. You use your core. Little guys like us can do it, but you've got to keep your core tight. How's it feel on your back?
Pretty good.
Looks nice and big. So when you're going up there, Jody, just little steps, mate. Don't take big strides, just little short ones.
Yeah.
Okay.
Where's that?
Little steps are better. Just like a gearing on a bike, you know? You know about that.
There's only on four as well. Hey, stop!
Well, I'm a filthy pig hunter from a poor town. Like to throw me dogs into the truck and drive around in the Golden Downs forestry. That's where you'll find me slaying sows and suckers and bring them home for tea. Filthy pig hunter, filthy pig hunter, filthy pig hunter, filthy pig hunter. Sounds like I'm saying hunter when I say hunter. Filthy pig hunter, 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 filthy pig hunter.
Good effort, fella. Put it there, man. Well done, boy.
Sure.
Well done, good effort. Welcome to the A-team. Okay. Oh,
done well.
Did very well.
Fucking well if you carried it from the bottom down there.
He did, all by himself. Good effort, man. Good pig, eh, John?
It is.
Fat as mud.
Got a hole. Not
bottle. In the front seat, Jody. On the ground.
Another nice Golden Downs boar there, Simon.
Yeah. Ripper.
Don't catch many up spooners like this, eh, Jody?
Not many.
If any. Poe's just licking the blood off bee. It's just a wee nick in her ear making a whole lot of blood. See, it's been bitten there by the pig. Sow's biting. BT's ear bitten. Superficial. Oh, post A. Stay in. Good dog. Stay there. Rightio. Time to feed you dogs. The sow bit bee's ear, so Poe's giving it a bit of a clean up. So some people hang them from here, so they're straight up, but that actually stretches the ham. So
yeah,
if you hang them this way, they get a nice tender roast. Chinese, curry chicken with potato. Not bad chomping and chewing. I'm really pleased how young Jody's going. He's now an official A team member. That means he's good enough to solo himself. Things he needs to learn still is knife work and also how to use his GPS better. Other than that, he's got all the skills. He's quiet, he's thoughtful about people around him, he's a good team player, and he's got a lot of natural talent. So well done, Jody, and welcome to the A team. Well, it was a bloody good hunt, eh? After that, Simon and I butchered the pig, and we gave probably most of it actually to Jody, who's made into sausages. Caught two pigs with him, so he's got heaps of sausages. This is the leg, or one of the legs, and it's semi-frozen because I've had it hanging in my fridge. I've got another fridge for just hanging meat, and what I do is I wind it up so it's almost freezing stuff. Well, it is, but not quite. So you can hang a pig for like a month and it's semi-frozen, and then you can take slices off with a sharp knife, which I'm doing right now. And that's what our slices look like, just that, nice and thin. Get back in the cooler. Heat in the pan, olive oil in. It's not for Bruno, no. Would you check out this garlic? Grown by one of the most beautiful human beings on the planet, Stu Driver. And he grows the best garlic too. He gives me this every year, he sends it to me. Probably could have skinned it a bit better, but hey, I don't even chop it up fine because I like to munch on it once it's been in the oil a while. Probably take that out the window for the chickens. That looks pretty damn good. There goes our ginger. Well, I haven't cut up too fine. Just gonna get that nice and hot. We're gonna place our pork on top of that. And the flavour of the ginger combined with the garlic is gonna rise up through the heat and through the pork. There's our wild pork, just with my hands, gonna lay it on top of that. I can already smell that ginger and garlic working together. Lid on, give it a couple minutes and come back to it. Vinegar, malt vinegar. You're probably going, what the hell? Yes, it does taste malty when you drink it. Tastes a wee bit sour. It also tastes bloody good. My daughter loves it, so it's good enough for me. What that's going to do is, it's going to break down that meat because it's so finely cut. It's going to get inside it and break it down more. Rightio, we are going to strain off this vinegar mostly. It's been in the vinegar cooking now for about 10 to 15 minutes. Back in the pan, back on, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to add this big chunk of butter. Pink Himalayan salt, frozen blueberries. I bet you didn't see that coming. I'm putting in a couple of handfuls of them. First time I had blueberries with meat was when I was in Sweden. It works. Now you want to give the blueberries just a couple of minutes. You don't want to overcook them. You want them to retain their nice firmness. They're not going too squishy. We're outside now because eating outside is fun. What I've done here is I've just put some kale and baby spinach on top after I turn it off, just to sort of like, just heat it up a little bit on the plate. So we're going to have that. I'm adding it to my other bits and pieces. And what I've got on here is I've got sauerkraut, beetkraut, kimchi, which is a Korean dish. It's sort of a little bit like sauerkraut, and some bean sprouts. And let's just pop some of our meat on. What do you reckon it's going to be like? Well, I've actually had a wee taste while I was cooking it, so I can tell you it tastes bloody awesome. The berries, they give it a sort of a European taste. Makes sense? When you're eating the meat with the berry, and the berry explodes in your mouth all over the meat, that's when you pop in half a garlic. That's the second meal today I've had. The first one was about 5:30 this morning. It's now probably 5 o'clock at night. That was delicious. So what you can do when you're eating it, if you want to spice it up a bit while eating it, just dig into a little bit of kimchi because it's really spicy and hot. Oh. I feel a bit rude eating in front of you guys, but that's it. That's my wild pork dish. You know, we've kind of lost touch with reality. The whole fabric of society has fallen down. There's people out there that don't know where bloody eggs come from. They look at their meat and a hamburger or in the supermarket and they give it no thought. One of the reasons I really love hunting, and probably the main reason really, well, there's a lot of reasons. I love working with other people. I love working with dogs. I love getting out there and using my body and my lungs and my heart and going hard, but it's got to be to get food off the hillside, isn't it? Anyway, good luck with your own hunting and your own cooking, and be good. If you can't be good, be careful. I'm going to tear into this while it's still warm. Just too bloody nice. Hey, Garney, want to sing you a very short, fast song? Well, I'm a filthy pig hunter from a poor town. Like to throw me dogs into the truck and drive around in the Golden Downs forestry. That's where you'll find me slaying sows and suckers and bring them home for tea. Filthy pig hunter, filthy pig hunter, filthy pig hunter, filthy pig hunter. Sounds like I'm saying hunter when I say hunter. Filthy pig hunter, 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 filthy pig hunter. G'day, Pace. How you going, boy? Hey, come here, boy. Hey,
good boy. Who's a good boy? He's a good dog.
Aren't ya? I'm sorry, mate, for looking at your girlfriend. I'm sorry, mate, for perving on your date. I'm sorry, mate, for looking at your girlfriend. I'm sorry, mate, for perving on your date. I love your youth, it's a bloody beaut. Like your quad bikes, got everything on. I'm sorry, mate, for perving at your girlfriend. I'm sorry, mate, for looking at your date. I'm sorry, mate, for looking at your girlfriend. Yeah, I'm sorry, mate, for gawking at your date. She's a bloody beaut. I love the look of your you. I like your quad bikes. You got everything I like. I'm sorry, mate, for perving at your girlfriend. I'm sorry, mate, for gawking at your date.